Are you a software or security engineer on call? Are you able to keep up with the alerts generated by your modern apps and infrastructure? Do you often feel overwhelmed by false alarms? Hi, I'm Bhaskar Manant from Sumo Logic. In this video, I'm delighted to introduce you to our breakthroughs in helping you reduce alert noise and accelerate application recovery through AI-driven alerting. AI-driven alerting packages two features. First, advanced anomaly detection in logs-based monitors helps you reduce alert noise. We call this feature anomaly monitors. Second, once a system finds an anomalous condition, AI-driven alerting also helps you reduce resolution time through automated playbooks. A playbook is a set of tasks in a workflow defined by developers or security engineers to respond to an incident. Playbooks can be used to automate diagnosis, recovery, and remediation. Sumo Logic Automation Service is a prerequisite for this capability. Anomaly monitors leverage a machine learning model to detect anomalies and identify unusual patterns. The output of the machine learning model are baselines for normal behavior in the form of lower and upper thresholds, such that deviations from these baselines signal unusual activity that should trigger alerts and require an investigation from developers or security engineers. Let's consider a scenario where a monitor detects suspicious behavior that could indicate a problem. When the monitor sends the alert, it could also run an automated playbook to respond to the alert. First, let's take a look at the anomaly monitor. For demo purposes, we have one already set up. You can see the monitor type is logs, and the detection method is selected as anomaly. At this time, anomaly monitor is designed to work for time-sliced log signals only. Here in the query section, you can review a query for the logs to be monitored for anomalous behavior. In the critical tab, under trigger type, check the parameters set for the alert trigger. Detection window. Here you can select the duration of time to watch for anomalies. Ensure that the detection window is 5 to 10 times longer than the time slice used in the log query. For example, with logs time sliced by the minute, use a detection window of at least 5 minutes. Detector sensitivity allows you to tune the number of anomalous data points detected per day. High sensitivity will result in more alerts, and low sensitivity will result in fewer alerts. Use high sensitivity if you do not want to miss out on most anomalies. Minimum anomaly count. Here you can specify the minimum number of anomalies to detect during the detection window before triggering an alert. These settings help you add context to anomaly detection. For example, if you know a particular signal is noisy, you may want to wait for a number of anomalous data points in the detection window before triggering an alert. If the detection window is set to 5 minutes and the minimum anomaly count is set to 1, then an alert is triggered if at least one anomaly appears within a 5 minute period. Also notice how the thresholds, once a model is trained, reflect the trends and seasonality in the logs data closely. Remember, if you change these settings or the log query, the model will be retrained. Model training takes several minutes, and during that time, the monitor status will remain updating model. You can view the advanced settings and notifications set in the new monitor window. In the monitor details section, you now have the option to select automated playbooks from the Sumo Logic Automation Service. Click in the field provided to set one or more playbooks that should run when the monitor triggers an alert. And then you save to save the monitor with the attached playbooks. Upon saving, a machine learning model is trained using historical data to learn baselines that reflect the expected value of the signal after factoring data seasonality, which could be hourly, daily, or weekly. Anomaly detection also leverages AutoML, automated machine learning, to select the best model parameters and seasonality without user input, a unique aspect of our approach. Remember, model training takes several minutes, and during that time, the monitor status will remain updating model. Once the monitor has completed training, you'll be able to preview its behavior in the monitor configuration historical trend. You can also view the monitor history to assess if the monitor is noisy and requires further tuning. From the monitor history or from a notification, click through to the alert response page to view the alert and its associated context. We'll have a separate video covering the functionality of automated playbooks. For now, more information about AI-driven alerting, please visit the help pages here. I hope this video helps you get started with AI-driven alerting, and in particular, anomaly monitors in Sumo Logic. Thank you for joining.